Hello from NETIO Products. Today, I would like to present a product called PowerPDU 8QS. Basically, it's one UPDU for your rack. It can be montaged from the front or from the side, or it can be even vertically or horizontally. Depends on the holders you want. In the standard package is included this holder for the one you montage, but you can order some other montage options. This product is basically PDU, so there is one power input for 16 amps, and 8 outputs, each one up to 10 amps. There is a power switching on each output. So basically you can open the web interface of this output, and on the web interface, you can switch on or switch off each one output. And for the total, so power input, power inlet, or for output number one, there is also metering of the power consumption and all energy consumption. As a tiny tip, there is also reverse energy. So it can also meter the energy which is going in the wrong direction from your photovoltaic or something like that. Anyway, this metering option is there available only on output number one. On the others, you can see there is only switch on and off. And this switch can be also dedicated by the scheduler. Scheduler is basically something that you can program. Each output will be switched on and switched off in a certain time or with the daylight or sunset. Main application for this product is basically remote restarting. For remote restarting, you can do it manually. So from the web interface of the unit, yes, nice. But sometimes you need to do it remotely where you are really not online or where you are really not connected to this network. So we support their feature called NETIO Cloud, which is a service. For 3 years, it's included in the price of the unit, then it's paid. And through the SSL, there is a connectivity with the device from the cloud, and you can control from this cloud all the devices connected to your user account. You can connect this user account also to your mobile app called NETIO Mobile2, and then from your packet, you can control all your NETIO devices anywhere you are. That's very nice for the remote starting manually. Sometimes you need to connect this for the application, so for your own software. Because of that, we support quite a lot of open API. So you can control this output through SNMP version 1 or version 3, through Modbus TCP, JSON, XML, and so on and so on. All these interfaces are fully documented on our website. Not everyone is a programmer. So in that case, you need a driver for your system. So if you have in your smart home or shop or something like that, control for Crestone, Brightsign, or some other system, this is the list of the supported audio video drivers. Of course, the drivers are more and more every day. Not all the drivers support even the reading of the power consumption and so on, but it depends on the driver. Sometimes it's quite useful to have a feature that this device realizes there is a problem. This device can realize autonomously there is a problem based on the several features. We have there something we call PAB, power analyze blocks. And based on that, we are able to detect that the power consumption on output number one dropped down from something like 100, 150 watts to 7 watts or 8 watts. That's a typical situation where your big TV screen hangs out, is switched automatically to the idle mode, and basically the TV is black. So we are able to detect that from the NETIO and restart your TV autonomously. And based on that, your TV can be continuously running. Second option to detect there is something wrong with the device is basically the pinging to the device. We call it IP watchdog. So basically port number 2 can ping to certain IP address. If there is no answer, restart the connectivity or switch on backup connectivity. That's also optional. Quite unique feature of this unit is this green terminal block. This green terminal block is basically one digital input and 12 volts output. So you can connect, for example, motion detector, motion sensor, and detect that in the room is someone already for last 30 minutes there was no movement or something like that, or there is a leaving button and you switch the button and based on that shut down half of the ports and some others keep running or something like that. That all can be realized with the PowerPDU 8QS. Thank you very much for watching this video and find more details on our website.